When they call you the God of Tekken, they expect you to destroy the competition.
And the Oki behind it, the Sonic Bang! Nii is your champion!
EVO 2013 champ!
Big guys!
Cafe is Nii!
But power isn't enough. Perfection is the goal.
Nii's been playing well his entire life. Ever since he's touched a controller for Tekken, he's been good at it. He didn't even have a bottle. He had an arcade stick with a Korean lever in that bad boy playing Tekken.
And gods have responsibilities to their community and to the future.
Today, that the game you basically play, you play well because of this guy.
Because when his reign is nothing more than history, future converts will look back and see that Nii is the god of Tekken. Bae Nii Jae-min was born on June 24th, 1985 in South Korea, and had he not been born when he was where he was, he might never have become the god of Tekken.
And Nii is widely considered as the best Tekken player of all time.
Of all time.
He took a liking to fighting games early in his life, and in the 90s, that meant arcades.
I really liked fighting games. So, like, Kyopara, Samurai Shodown,
A financial crisis in Asia caused suppliers of popular fighting game arcade cabinets to stop shipping to South Korea. Slowly, the selection of games dwindled, and that pushed him toward Tekken.
20살쯤 됐을 때는 오락실에 게임 철권밖에 없더라고요. 뭐 킹오파는 그 당시에 이제 거의 안 나오기 시작했고 보츠오 파이터도 안 나오기 시작했거든요. 그래서 남은 게 이제 철권이었는데 뭐 꾸준히 하다 보니 계속 하게 된 게 철권이고.
He chose his handle when he joined a community Tekken website. Since his chosen team for Tekken Tag Tournament, Brian and Bruce, made full use of their Nii's, he chose Nii. So, starting in 2004, Nii threw himself into the game.
제가 2004년에 이제 대회를 이제 처음으로 나가서 3등을 했었는데 그때 이제 사람들이 뭐 축하한다 뭐 이런 것들을 받고 그러다 보니까 갑자기 이제 우승에 대한 그런 욕심이 생기다 보니까 이 게임을 제일 잘하고 싶다는 생각이 들어서 그때부터 진지하게 하기 시작했습니다.
Those 3 years saw Nii rise to the highest level in his region playing Tekken 5, and much of it took place on the head-to-head setups at the legendary Green Arcade in Seoul.
I mean, it was the mecca of Tekken. All of the top Korean players played there, basically. Well, players would travel there and they would go into the arcade and they said it was so surreal because all of these Tekken gods you had been hearing about, you just go in and they're all sitting there in a row, just playing Tekken against each other. And that's what they did, you know.
Traveling was not an option, but domestically, Nii had become a top pro. His approach to Brian had literally rewritten the book on the character.
I still remember some of the first matches I saw of him in Tekken 5 and the Brian combos he was doing. All the way back in 2006, he was doing as absurd combos. It was like he matured very early as a top player and he's just been at that level ever since.
But being a Tekken pro in South Korea in the mid-2000s was not exactly a life of luxury. The decade had seen a massive surge in Korean esports, but for a very different title, StarCraft.
Korea wins! Korea wins StarCraft! Again,
by 2007, Nii was reconsidering the 3 years he had invested in professional Tekken. He resolved to play one last tournament at the Green Arcade, Tekken 5 DRS Fight.
2007년에 이제 마지막 그 철권 5 대회가 열렸었는데 그때 한국 최고수들이 다 모였던 대회에서 제가 그 제일 잘한다는 팀을 저 혼자 이제 이기고 우승했을 때 딱 모든 사람들이 무릎이 최고다 뭐 그런 얘기를 했습니다.
And with his place at the top of Korea's scene secure, Nii decided to serve his mandatory military service, an obstacle that all South Korean players eventually face. Around him, his friends and relatives were moving forward with their lives, and it felt like it was time for him to move on with his.
제가 20대 초반에 이제 철권을 제일 잘하고 싶어서 열심히 했었는데 그때 저는 이제 대학교도 그만두고 오직 이제 철권에만 몰두를 했었는데 한국에서는 이제 좋은 대학을 나와서 좋은 직장에 취업하고 뭐 결혼을 하고 막 이런 게 이제 좀 단계별로 있는데 저는 아예 그쪽에 전혀 관련이 없다 보니까 뭔가 사회적으로 실패한 게 아닐까. 그래서 군대를 갔다 오면 철권을 그만두고 나도 뭐 공부를 해서 대학교를 가고 좋은 직장을 찾고 뭐 그런 생각을 한 적이 있었습니다.
Footage began to leak onto the internet of Nee, his military service now complete, playing once more at the Green Arcade.
어? 어? 설마? 설마? 에이, 어? 배려군모? 어, 이분 앞뒤씨 했는데, 와!
The legend had truly returned to Tekken, and in Tekken Crash Season 4, fans got to see his team defeat the region's best in a huge televised tournament that showed Tekken was surging in popularity in South Korea.
뻗으라는 거 손에 뻗으라고 제가 일부러 가주는 거거든요?
무릎의 움직임이라며 그게 파이가 가능할 거라고 말씀을 드렸거든요?
자, 라이트닝 블로우도 막혔고
라이트닝?
라이트닝! 자, 시간차로 개미를 뽑면서 KO 시킵니다. 아...
시즌4에서 나가서 뭐 돌아온 무릎 뭐 이런 식으로 해가지고 뭐 어쨌든 이제 우승까지 하게 되면서 아... 다시 또 재밌는 거예요, 이게.
In 2010, fighting games as a genre were back in a big way. The release of Street Fighter IV in 2009 had brought a new generation into the fold, and there was a growing interest in the genre.
Brian coming out very huge, looking to take another round. Nee, there it is, Nee takes two. One more, and he will be your gold medalist.
그동안에는 사실 제가 철권 대회를 나갔을 때는 뭐 오락실 대회나 아니면은 뭐 약간 규모 있는 대회? 근데 이제 WCG 같은 경우는 워낙 그때 세계적인 대회였고 거기 가서 이제 철권을 우승했다는 게 뭐랄까 저는 그때 막 그 당시 이제 스타크래프트라 막 그런 것들이 엄청 이제 큰 대회였었는데 거기에 철권도 같이 있었다는 게 좀 저는 좀 감명이 깊어서 그런 것도 있고 메달을 한번 처음 걸어봤던 거라서 기억에 남습니다.
Your world champion for Tekken 6 here, the World Cyber Games. Put your hands together for the one and only Nee.
Nee was finally ready to show that not only was he back, he was the world's best Tekken player.
Oh wow, what an electric. Nice up four option. Wow, is Nee gonna make a full comeback? He does! And Bronson with a clutch move there. Wow, so right now, Nee is up 2-1 over Bronson Tran.
What he wants right here.
Oh, that's gonna be. Oh my god, this is it! Bronson Tran loses and gets second place. South Korea's Cafe It's Nee takes it.
And give it up to your champion, his very first EVO.
While the game had its own hungry and dedicated community, Tekken itself was going through some lean times. Tekken Tag Tournament 2 was not an easy game. It did make one more appearance at EVO in 2014, but it took the complexity of a regular Tekken title and cranked it up. And it was just too much for some players.
50 characters and being forced to lab a gazillion characters because guess what? You're always facing two characters. You always needed a shitload of character knowledge in this game, and it was just overcrowded, too many characters.
Even with the announcement of Tekken 7 at EVO 2014, there were challenges ahead. Nee took the advice of fellow competitor Kang Chanel Seung-ho, and by mid-2014, he was regularly live-streaming his Tekken play on Afrika TV.
Ah, 낚시가 안 걸리다니. 제발! 아, 이렇게 내가 지금...
In Nee's early days, he was known for playing characters like Brian and Bruce, but he had always had a deep knowledge of the game's matchups and a strong pool of characters that he could employ.
이건 이제 뭐 요즘에 개인 방송을 할 때 시청자들이 이제 여러 캐릭터들을 보고 싶어 하니까 그것을 이제 좀 잘하는 모습을 보여주기 위해서 연습을 하다 보니까 거의 모든 캐릭터를 하게 됐습니다.
Rather than focusing exclusively on a handful of characters, Nee embraced counter picks, learning matchups and adjusting his strategy against his opponent's chosen fighters, even as he embodied the legendary Korean approach to Tekken known as perfect play.
Nee, for the longest time, has been pretty much the greatest version of this type of play. He knows every single frame, he respects the frames, he knows always how to stay as safe as possible while getting as much rewards as possible. You can see this reflected in his character picks as well.
Over the next few years, he took his multi-character approach to an extreme, eventually taking every character in Tekken 7 to Tekken God Prime, that game's highest rank. And maybe even more than an Evo appearance, his streams, usually hours long and filled with high-level Tekken, helped him reach a wider audience both at home and abroad. But Nee wanted more. He wanted the game he loved to thrive. So he started hosting tournaments on his own.
일단은 이제 제가 오랫동안 한국에서 철권을 했다 보니까 제 다음 세대들도 뭔가 철권을 좀 더 재밌게 했으면 좋겠다고 생각을 했는데 그런 기회가 없었어요. 그래서 제가 한번 그런 자리를 만들어 본 게 어떨까 해서 그런 이제 제 이름으로 대회를 열었었는데 많은 사람들이 또 즐겁게 놀고 하는 모습이 좋아서 꾸준히 열게 됐습니다.
Despite Nee's best efforts, the future of the game's competitive scene was uncertain. Tekken 7 released in arcades in 2015, but wouldn't get a console release in North America until 2017. That didn't stop Nee, who continued to compete as much as possible, taking second at big tournaments like the King of the Iron Fist 2015 Finals and Evo 2016. But Tekken 7 released on consoles at the perfect moment. Competitors like Street Fighter and Marvel vs. Capcom were on the back foot. And the 31-year-old Nee could rest easy, assured that the Tekken that he had steadily learned and lovingly preserved had not withered away. Instead, it grew tremendously, its roots digging still deeper into the fighting game community.
The development, the boom, and everything, and once people kind of got their hands on the game and got to play it for themselves, I think the rest of it took care of itself.
They're really supporting the game. Like never before. They didn't even support Tag 2 like this with so many different DLC packs, you know, going to so many events and supporting that way with pop bonuses, getting partnered with Twitch and everything.
예전에 제가 굉장히 좀 바랬던 모습이 이런 모습인데 왜냐면 저도 이제 격투 게임을 해왔지만은 사실상 스트리트 파이터가 워낙 이제 컸다 보니까 항상 부러웠어요. 그런 이제 격투 씬이. 근데 철권이 월드 투어가 생기고 많은 사람들이 하면서 이제 뭔가 그런 격차가 줄어들고 자리 잡아가는 걸 보니까 저는 뭐 굉장히 좋고 제가 좀 더 젊었을 때 이런 게 있었으면 어땠을까 그런 생각합니다.
The growth meant a big opportunity. The Korean esports organization ROC signed him in August of 2017, which made him one of the few Korean Tekken players to have a major sponsor and gave him more opportunities than ever to travel and compete. He won Evo Japan, solidifying his place at age 32 as the greatest Tekken player.
Oh, big back one!
Oh, this is gonna be close. It's not gonna be enough to kill.
It's gonna be very, very close though. And the Oki behind
oh,
it, the Sonic Bang!
The Nee. Second hit.
Nee is your champion for Evo Japan 2018. The legend is back.
But Nee's newfound ability to consistently travel would bring him his biggest challenge yet. For years, Nee had played against the world's best. He had conquered Korea, then traveled to Japan and later the United States to face the strongest players and learn their approach to Tekken. But something happened in 2018 as the game's continued growth pushed new players into the spotlight. At OUG 2018 in Dubai, Nee ran into a player from Pakistan that he simply could not defeat, Arslan Ash.
Okay, it's wow.
Wow, catch
really good option from Arslan.
Oh, into the tiger.
Punish. Oh god. Oh god.
Oh boy.
Oh god.
And that's it. Wow.
Nee beat.
Nee gets beaten by Arslan.
Is beat by Arslan 3-0. OUG tournament. Congratulations to Arslan from Pakistan.
holy hell, like this Arslan guy is an, you know, beast mode Tekken player. But everyone still felt like, must have been a fluke. You know, we're talking about Neve, the Tekken god since 14 years back. He must have been sick. He must have been tired. You know, everyone kept making excuses, but very apparent Arslan is also, you know, a godlike player.
The new style was intriguing, but Neve wouldn't be able to face Arslan again until several months later at EVO Japan 2019, when he lost to Arslan again early in the bracket in an unstreamed match.
Suddenly it's apparent to everyone that, okay, so the best Tekken player in the world is from Pakistan. How is this possible? And to me, it's just obvious that a monster is not created in a vacuum. You know, you become a monster by playing other monsters. It goes back to what we said previously, that, you know, to become strong, you have to train with strong people.
Nee knew immediately that he had to understand not only Arslan, but the strength of the Pakistani scene entirely. He had to learn about this branch of the Tekken tree that, until recently, was hidden from him.
일단은 이제 파키스탄이라는 나라가 사실 철권에서는 전혀 이제 이름이 없었던 나라였는데 처음으로 파키스탄 철권이 강하다는 걸 알 수가 있었고 저도 그 선수랑 많이 게임하면서 저 자신도 실력이 올라가는 걸 느꼈기 때문에 저는 그 선수랑 게임했던 게 굉장히 저한테 많은 도움이 됐다고 생각합니다.
But because of some government travel restrictions, going to Pakistan wasn't immediately possible for Nee. Both players went to the True Gaming Invitational in Saudi Arabia, and when they missed each other in the bracket, they played a couple of short sets, which Arslan won. When Nee heard that Arslan would be back in Japan in May 2019, he immediately booked a ticket and left, hoping to play him in a long set. He got what he wanted, and even got a favorable result, winning two of the three first to tens they played.
Rage 状態, 診療, 残る 1 ミリ, 勝ったのは, 神が, 許, Time up. 3!
Ah, Nee が 勝った!
Thankfully, 2019 was the biggest year for Tekken ever, and viewers were treated to an incredible saga. Even as Nee amassed enough points to become the top player in the Tekken World Tour standings, he had yet to take a tournament set off of Arslan.
지금 이제 아슬란 선수랑 많이 이제 하면서 제가 초반에 많이 졌었는데 저는 뭐 그런 게 기분 나쁘지 않았어요. 왜냐면은 되게 신선한 이제 경험이었고 이 선수랑 많이 게임하면서 많은 사람들이 그랬어요. 무릎이 아슬란이랑 게임하고 나서 뭔가 더 잘하는 것 같다. 그래서 저는 뭐 라이벌 그런 게 전혀 기분 나쁘지 않고 오히려 좋습니다.
At Tiger Uppercut 2019, Arslan met Nee in the Grand Finals in an absolutely nail-biting match.
Oh my god! Oh my god! Let it rip! Oh my god!
While standing four, holy shit! I see drive, rake kick. Oh, went for the grab. Caught knee top kick, 1-2.
1-1-2. Oh my god, goes for the low!
Arslan Ash. But at this point, the mental pressure's on Nee.
You gotta do something.
Shady jabs in mid-range.
Oh my god.
Oh my god!
That should be it!
Arslan Ash!
Is that it? That's it!
Tiger Uppercut 2019, and from Pakistan, Arslan Ash over Nee in Grand Finals.
And then, at EVO 2019, with the whole world watching, Arslan and Nee clashed in the Grand Finals once more, with Nee initially trying to use Kazuya's mix-up against Arslan's patient defense.
Wow. And just like that, Arslan Ash, I mean, so dominant
what a
out
statement
of Pakistan.
There.
This is crazy.
Okay, got a favorite real quick for everyone watching at home. Nee is now stuck. He has to pick one character to win this set, and if he doesn't do it, it's all over.
It's hard to even imagine what can be done at this point. Look at Nee. Have you ever thought that Nee would look like this, perplexed as to how to beat his opponent?
But forced back onto his Devil Jin, Nee evened the series, and things were as close as ever.
Nee.
Trying to stay alive.
Interrupted! That's what he needed! Yes! Rage is a huge deal here.
Woo! Oh, again! Again!
Wow, look at Nee!
Look at me! Look at the crowd! Oh my god!
Sitting on that stage, Nee saw that Arslan still had the edge, but neither man was willing to back down.
What's gonna happen right now? Nee looking for this opportunity.
I'm holding my breath.
Oh! They trade blows.
Oh man, that was a crazy trade. Arslan cementing his position as the best Tekken player on the planet, untouchable.
So with the Tekken World Tour finals looming, Nee followed through on his promise. He finally made it to Pakistan, and the 2007 version of Nee, the one who worried about wasting his life, ready to turn away from Tekken for a normal career, could never have imagined what he found there.
Today, that the game you basically play, you play well because of this guy. Yeah. 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 We have tons of services for the game, and we have the legend in-house with us right now.
Nee never consciously helped the Pakistani scene grow, but it happened anyways, because his example helped inspire a generation of players, because he encouraged others to join him in learning everything about Tekken, even when it didn't pay the bills, because he refused to give up on the game that had given him so much. The last major tournament of 2019 was the Tekken World Tour Finals, and Nee had a score to settle.
So have a look, you have the choice because you're number one on the leaderboard. Which group do you want to be in? You can now see all the players.
A.
A!
Oh my a. God! This is crazy, because remember, only two players of each pool are going to make it out into our top eight.
He's got history with Arslan.
I think everybody in the world is looking at these two guys and saying, we want to see this, we want to see blood in the finals. And you got to fight for your life right here, right now.
Same mistake we saw earlier from him. And that will be round number one for Arslan Ash. Shredded for the respawn. Hella damage. Side to three. Nee gets the perfect.
Running back.
10 seconds on the clock. The flash was coming. Not yet. The low. Unbelievable. Arslan Ash gets the first game.
Nee, what is your response?
Oh, God.
If Arslan Ash wins this 2-0, he's going to get in over you. Nee. What is your answer to this entire year of competition right here, right now?
Oh my God!
Jeff on the drive!
Jeff for the float! Nee's gonna get the round! Close out the deafness! I don't got no nerves! Watch this!
That's an important rebound round. He's gonna hit the wall.
It's not enough to kill.
One more chance, Arslan Ash!
Arslan Ash's tournament life is over!
Oh my God, Nee! The set ain't over yet, but that with 1-1.
Because of the group stage rules, winning one game and denying Arslan a 2-0 victory meant that Nee would advance over him. But the rest of the set had to be played.
Oh, no, wait, but it's just a little bit too slow.
Well, how did that miss? Second and miss. Straight into range arc. Nee gonna cancel?
Yeah, the cancel.
Gonna go for the combo here. While not gonna matter. Yeah. Nee gonna take the set. Man, he put both his arms up after that. Nee gets it done against Arslan Ash 2-1 here.
Nee placed third, a respectable finish, which earned him $37,500, the single biggest prize of his career. But more than anything else, that set must have been an incredible weight off Nee's shoulders. Nee is a huge part of Tekken's past, but he isn't ready to give up on the game he loves yet, and he needed to show that to Arslan, because the man who loved the game, even when it was difficult to do so, still has more to give.
뭐 굉장히 어렸을 때부터 이제 게임을 해왔었는데 사실상 뭐 중간에 다른 일도 한번 해봤었지만은 결국 저랑은 맞지 않았고 이제 제가 가야 될 길은 이 격투 게임 프로 게임을 갖고 철권은 사실 뭐 태어나서 거의 지금까지 계속 해오다 보니까 인생이나 마찬가지입니다.
Thanks for watching. If you want more content like this, hit the sub button and ring that notification bell. For unique bite-sized videos you won't find anywhere else, hit up our Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook pages.